I don't wanna be the girl.
Hello girl, today I am coming with an idea haul video. This is just not about showing what I've got, but to give you the tip that I found a place online where you can buy samples of MAC pigments and glitters. The good thing about it is that you will be having a fourth of a tablespoon to work with and try them on and see if you actually like the color, if it works for you, and then you will be ready to buy the real big container that it's about $16, I think. It is also good for the ones who live outside the States and for those countries where you do not have a MAC store, like my country, where I don't have a MAC store. So that's one of the reasons why I also ordered, to see which ones I would like and then purchase the big and regular size one. So let's get started with this haul. Oh, and one thing, I'm also going to be showing you some brushes that I've got from CosmoSense. One pretty good and the other one, you're going to see my review of it. I just used it once and I'm quite disappointed, but keep on watching if you're interested about this MAC sample pigments and glitters and the brushes, okay? See ya. The place that I'm talking about, it's called The Body Meets. This is about what you're going to receive. This is about what you're going to receive. Let me. The great idea is that they placed a little sticker over here with the name of the pigment. This is, for example, 3D Cooper. And I'm going to show you, this has really lovely sparkles. And I also got Pink Bronze. This is a pigment and it's kind of a bright bronze or orange pigment. Really, really nice. Really bright. I got this lovely green that I was hearing everybody, and it's called Golden Olive. I'm not sure if you can see that. Let me open it. Ooh, look at this. You see, it's a really little sample, but it gives you an idea if you would like to purchase the big one or not. For me, this is really important because we don't have MAC stores. So if I want to buy something from MAC, I have to order it in Nordstrom. And I really want to be sure that this is the color I want. This is Frozen White and I'm wearing this today. It's a lovely color. It has some really nice sparkle. Frozen White. I really recommend this one. I think that this is one that I'm going to be getting in a big size. And this one as well. I just fell in love with this look. This is a cold silver fog. And this is what I'm wearing on my lower lid. It's like a silver. It's not too dark, but it's just lovely. And I'm wearing this also on my lower lid. And this is great. This is a purple, deep purple. It's dark, actually. I don't know why it looks like blue, but it's completely purple. Believe me. Completely purple. Then I ordered a glitter sample. It's called Reflects Pearl. Beautiful. Oh, I'm not sure you can actually see it because... Oh no! Oh great, I just spilled some of it. Well, I would be placing it here to give it a share. I'm not going to throw it away. It is just spectacular. I'm buying this one as well. Oh yeah. Ooh, I'm look. Now I look like a Christmas ornament, don't I? Yeah, well. Okay, so that one was Reflects Pearl. Then I also ordered this one, which is called Rose. This is a pigment and it's... You gotta see this. Girls, isn't it great? Look at this. It's a really, really beautiful color. And it's called Rose. It has some golden sparkle to it. And this is how it looks like. Ooh. Then I ordered corn flour. And this is a pigment, so that won't be a problem. And this pigment is really nice. It's like between blue. It's between blue and blue and purple, I would say. They gave me a sample for free, yay! And this one is called Reflex Black Kent Red Glitter Brown. It's even smaller. Yeah, it is. Look at this. Yeah, it is smaller. It's like half of what I ordered. So it will last me like for 2 or 3 applications. But it's really nice and it's truly appreciated. I will try it on. Then I wanted to talk about the Castle Sense brushes that I've got. Then I also ordered some Castle Sense brushes. I have washed them, see them how they shed or not, and I've used only 2 of them already. To start with the good one, I like this one really much. This is the Italian Badger Blush Brush, and it's soft, as you cannot imagine. It really applies really nicely your blush, and I also tried it on as a contour for my cheeks, and it does it. I mean, it does the work, even though I rather the angled one that I have from Muscle Sense. And this is really nice. It didn't shed a hair. It didn't shed at all. I mean, it was really, really good. And I would recommend this already. I mean, I'm already loving it. Now, what I'm really disappointed is this one. This is from Castle Sense, and let me tell you the name. Oh, it doesn't have a name on the handle. Okay, I got it. Just 1 sec. It's the Silver Duo Fiber Sleeping Stippling Brush. Sorry. This one shed like tamed black. And then it shed some hairs out, and I was like, okay, it is a full brush, but it's not like, I mean, this one, it's even fuller than this one, and it didn't shed. And I was like, okay, so maybe that's normal because it has these little white bristles. And then I tried it, applying my foundation with it, and I had like hairs all on my face, and I was like, okay. Then the handle just went apart. I glue it back. I don't know why. It just, okay, I don't want to mess it up again, but the handle came back when I was washing it, and I was like, shoot, gotta be kidding me, because I really heard that it was really good, and I'm not loving it, okay? That's my opinion so far. I don't like the fact of having these hair strings on my face and just have to take them off my face, because this is not what you're supposed to have with this one. And these ones, I'm just going to show them to you because I haven't really used them yet, because I got my 217 for MAC and I'm just loving it. I'm sorry guys, this is wonderful. Okay, but talking about Castle Sense, I got the blending brush, which is huge. I mean, look at this. It's really small handle, and it's the blending fluff actually, and it's really, 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 I don't know, it's too soft to me. I'm not sure if it's going to blend that well. I gotta try it, so I'm not going to review it yet, but I was expecting something a little bit different, to be honest. Then I have this one, which I haven't used yet. I did wash it though, and it didn't shed. It is really behaving very nicely. This is called the Tapered Crease Eye Brush, and they say it is comparable to MAC 226. I am not sure it is comparable to MAC 26, because from what I've seen, I don't have it, but from what I've seen, the MAC 226 is a little bit longer in the Brussels than this. And this is called Italian Badger Doe Foot Stipper. And it is quite thick here. It's kind of thick. It does have some angle. And I'm not sure how to use this. to be honest. I know how to use this. I know this might be for the crease and you can actually use it here. But I don't know if it's going to blend well or if it's just going to pack on the color too heavily. I'm not sure. So I'm going to tell you about that later because I have no idea. Okay, so that's enough. I think you're already bored of this yada yada. And I just wanted to thank you for keep watching the video, all of it. If you went through this part, then you watch it all. And thank you so much for watching. Let me know what do you think about these products. If you would like to have them, don't hesitate to purchase them. They're really nice to work with. See you next time and take care, guys.